Hello, I think we're live. And I'm Tamara.
Hi.
This is Carissa
from Creative Green Living.
Creative Green Living, and we're here to talk about lead in baby bottles, which is an issue. We found lead in this brand of baby bottle and this brand of baby bottle, and then a follower found lead in this brand of baby bottle. And so we asked people to ship us some new, and these we received new in the mail in 2018, January 2018, this year, this week. So I'm going to ask Carissa to open those packages while I talk to you about the concern in general. So this is the Pure Kiki baby bottle. Again, new in the box, came in these Amazon boxes right here. And this is an insulated one. And we don't know if this one in particular has lead, but the previous ones that were tested did. And if you can see along the edge, this bottom cap has a seam, and the lead is underneath this. So if the bottom cap comes off, and it has come off a lot for people who have sent me emails, their child uses it normal way, they throw it or they bump it, and, oh, hold on a second. Hey, Katie, Charlie's up. there might be a little nudie child running through here. Hopefully he won't be too. Anyway, so this, all my children are home right now. The seam, if this pops off, then the lead is available to the child. The company says that in normal use, it doesn't pop off. In our experience from our users, I mean our followers who use this, it does pop off. And then the child, one mom said how her baby stuck it in the bowl of oatmeal on a regular basis. With the exposed lead dot.
And that's so great.
Because people don't always know what we mean by the exposed lead dot, we have this corksicle that was sent in by somebody.
Yeah, I'll hold it closer.
Yeah, and there's a dot on the bottom.
So you can see in the center.
There's a dimple.
Right there, in the middle of that dimple, that's what we're talking about.
And that dot is usually a drop of lead, of solid lead, like 100% lead. And what we're going to do is show you that that is lead. So first we've got some lead check swabs. And I want to show you, when you open the package, the first thing you do when you open a package of lead check swabs is you should take this confirmation card and chuck it in the trash. Never, the confirmation card is pretty much useless. And the other thing I wanted to show is Carissa's unpacking these. These are new. We were told that this Green Sprouts iPlay Sippy Cup, they would be shipping without the markings. These are new that we got just now on Amazon, shipped to us, and both have the markings that have previously tested positive as lead paint
in two different colors
at 5,000 parts per million, 3,000 parts per million, depending on how much was in the screen.
Yeah.
So the consideration we have here is that, and I'm sorry I'm talking so fast.
That's okay.
The consideration is that this was determined by the Consumer Product Safety Commission to be legal. It is a legal amount of lead paint to have on a baby bottle. So the problem is with the regulations and the legislation, and we as consumers need to demand that the CPSC not allow lead paint on a baby bottle. These may be not lead paint. We'll find out in a minute.
Yeah, hopefully they aren't.
Hopefully they've redone these without lead paint, but they look just like the ones that have the lead paint on them previously.
So last year, if this is not an issue you're familiar with, we had tested, or Tamara had tested these. We've done several with lead check swabs as well as with the XRF, like she mentioned. And when we brought it to Green Sprout's attention, because of the outcry of parents who were so mad that there's highly leaded paint on their kids' baby bottles, they said that they were going to start only distributed unpainted bottles. They said that it complied with all CPSC standards, even though it was very high lead, because if you scrape all of the paint off of this and you weigh it, it weighed less than 1 milligram, and so therefore it was in compliance with CPSC regulations, which I think is bogus. I don't want any leaded paint anything on my kids' sippy cups and baby bottles, and I'm really concerned that there's still paint on here at all, because they obviously didn't intentionally source lead paint. Somehow it got on there, and I thought that they were smart to get rid of the markings because that eliminates the risk, but it's still here.
And then this is the Havia baby glass bottle with natural rubber cover. And again, we haven't tested this yet, so this may be negative, but our friend and follower tested it. She's asked to remain anonymous.
That's fine.
And this also, it has, you want to hold it up, has that paint on the outside, which has tested positive for lead, not by us, but by someone else. So we got one of those sent to us to see if it would test positive for lead.
That's brand new.
So we're going to show all of these real quick, and then we'll have probably a right up afterwards, so
we'll
cover the details.
Yes.
So I want to show you a swab. So the swab has liquid and powder, and it has two little things that say crush and crush, crush, crush. And what I like to do is squeeze the yellow liquid that results onto a surface that I know is not lead. It's the orangey yellow liquid. So I'm going to squeeze it onto this right here. And instead of using the swab, I'm going to use a Q-tip. And I just want to show you for sure, this is the bottom of the corksicle, what it looks like when we know it's lead. And it turns bright pink red right away. Carissa, hold it up close. So that's one.
So you can see this is bright pink, bright red. It turned right away. There's no question whether or not this is positive.
Can you hold it closer?
Yeah, well, the light's kind of washed out a little bit.
Yeah, you can see it. There you go. We'll post.
So it's red. Yeah, we'll post close-up photos of it. So we'll
and
do that.
So right now we're doing the Hevea baby bottle. And again, I haven't tested this myself until now.
It's turning red.
And it's turning
really
bright
red.
Yeah. So the Hevea baby bottle, it turned really bright red. Really quickly.
So these are bright red on this painted marking. And these 3M swabs that we are using are really designed to test paint. They're specifically designed to test house paint. And so the trigger point for when it turns red is 600 parts per million or higher. The CPSC guideline for lead in items intended for children is 90 parts per million. So that it is triggering positive means that it is at least six times higher than the CPSC guideline for lead in items intended for children. So this is a problem.
This green sprouts, again, it's hard to see with how bright the light is. This tested positive just now as well.
So this one's also positive.
This new green sprouts also has lead. And then we're going to do one last green sprouts. And then later we'll do XRF testing of these exact ones.
And the XRF is different because the XRF is a precision scientific instrument that can test for the exact amount of lead that is in the paint for whatever we can get to fill the sculpt. These just tell us yes or no, it's higher than 600 parts per million. The XRF will tell us exactly how much lead is there.
And so this green sprouts one
also
tested
positive.
So
you can see this
and
one.
We'll take pictures with appropriate flash with these swabs for each of these that tested positive. And so what we have now is we know these new baby bottles that are being shipped in 2018 in January still have lead paint, including this new Hevea one that we hadn't previously tested.
Right.
And we showed you an example of what the lead sealing dot is on a lot of the water bottles, including the baby bottles. And we are going to... We're going to stress test this.
Yes.
We're going to have a kiddo use this and see how quickly the bottom falls off.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to test the bottom and see if it's lead.
Right.
They have said, this company has said they are replacing the bottom with the sealing dot with the unleaded sealing dot. So
right.
This may, in fact, be a new one without the sealing dot. But we wanted to make sure one that we ordered in 2018, received in 2018, was tested to determine whether or not there's lead on the bottom.
Great.
I think that's
Thank you.
Yeah. Got everything?
I think that's it, too.
So her website is creativegreenliving.com. My website's letsafemama.com. And you can go to our websites for more information. We'll also create blog posts about this. And please share this with your friends. There's no baby bottle. There's no baby bottle that should have lead. And
have lead.
The Avent baby bottles that I've tested have writing on the outside, but they're lead-free. And so I definitely recommend those. And there's a few other brands I've tested that are lead-free. Just try and avoid the ones with painted writing in the meantime.
So and there's currently a write-up about the last time we did this testing, which was from January of last year. If you go to either creativegreenliving.com or letsafemama.com and search for Sippy Cup, information will come up, and you can read about last year. We're going to write a new one sometime, probably in the next 24 hours.
Yes.
Yeah. And then we'll put new information up, and we'll link it in this video, so you can follow or save this video, and then come back and find it in the description.
Someone said, what does the bottom, I can't tell what the rest of that said. So the bottom we're talking about is the pure, I'm a pure Kiki, it looks similar to this.
Once the cap breaks
off.
Right now it has a cap on it.
It has a little cap with a seam right there, and that's only the insulated ones.
And the hope is that it's not leaded once we get it open, but we're going to find out, and then we'll let you guys know what happens.
Thanks for tuning
in. Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.